friends, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in the new academic year 2021 and 22. Okay, so as we know now, you have entered in the 7th standard, and now in the 7th standard you will learn the science in the 3 sessions. Okay, so some lessons you will learn into the physics, some lessons you will learn into the chemistry, and some lessons we will discuss in the biology. Okay, so this year I am going to teach you biology. So, if we talk about the biology, biology means what? In this stream, or in this the stream of the science, we are doing the study about the plants and the animals and the different life processes of the plants and the animals. Okay, so this year I am going to teach about the biology, and from the biology today we are going to start the first lesson, and the name of the lesson is that nutrition in plants. Okay, so as we know that in the 6th standard you have discussed about the components of the food. So now what is mean by the components of the food? If I ask like this question, then what will be your answer? You will tell me that we can say that carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins, all these are the different components of the food. Okay, so all these components of the foods are only called as what? Nutrients. Okay, so what is mean by nutrients? Nutrients means what? The components of food are necessary for our body and are called nutrients. Okay, so the components which are necessary for our body, okay, the components which are necessary for our body, that components are called as nutrients. So if you see in our surrounding, we can see the plants, we can see the animals. Along with the plants and animals, we can see the human beings also. Okay, so if we talk about the plants, so as we know that we are learning, or you have discussed from the standard 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th, that plants can make their own food. Okay, so for their food purpose, the plants are doesn't depends on anyone. They are making their own food. Okay, but if we talk about the animals, then for the nutrients or for the component purpose or for their food purpose, they are totally depends on other, including human beings also. Okay, so what I said right now, the plants can make their own food, but animals and human beings cannot make their own food. For the need of the food, they are depends on the other. Okay, so the next one we will discuss that mode of nutrition in plants. Okay, mode of nutrition in plants. So right now I said that the plants can make their own food, but to make that own food, the plants also require some raw material. And which are the raw materials? To make their own food, plants requires water, sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, so these are, and a very important thing is that they also requires the carbon dioxide. So along with all these raw materials, the plants can make their own food and fulfill the need of their nutrients. Okay, next one is that plants also requires the food, animals also requires the food, human beings also requires the food. But my dear students, do you have ever think why we need the food? Yes, why we need the food? Then for that we are having the some reasons why we need the food. We need the food to build their bodies. Okay, so the animals, plants, or we can say the living organisms needs the food to build their bodies. Next word, the living organisms needs the food to grow. For the proper growth of their body, they requires the food. Next one is that to repair damaged parts of the body. Okay, sometimes we are having some cuts or wounds on our body, but it get, as the time pass, it get heal out. How this happens? With the help of the different types of the nutrients. Okay, so in this way, what we can say that the nutrients, or we can say from the food we can get that nutrients, and why we require that nutrients? To repair our damaged parts of the body. So to build our body, to grow, to repair, to the wear and tear of our body, we require the food. From that foods we get the nutrients, and all these other needs can get fulfilled with the help of the different
nutrients. Okay.
So this is about what mode of nutrition in plant. Okay. But what is the name of our lesson? That is what nutrition in animal, nutrition in plants. Okay. So now we will discuss about what is mean by exactly nutrition. What is mean by nutrition? So let's see the definition of the nutrition. Nutrition is the mode of taking food by an organism and its utilization by the body. Okay, what is mean by the nutrition? Nutrition, it is the mode of taking food. Okay, nutrition means what? We are taking the food inside our body. But once we take that food inside our body, what happens with that food? It gets digested, it gives us energy. And then that energy is get utilized by the body. Okay, then the production of that energy takes place and that energy is get utilized by our body. Okay. So see, again I will repeat, is the mode of taking food by an organism. Means we are taking food inside, that food produces the energy and its utilization by the body, and then that food, that energy is utilized by an organism to perform the different activities, to perform the different tasks. Okay, so this is about what? Nutrition. Okay, so in the plants we can see the two types of the nutrition. Okay, so or in the living organisms we can see the two types of the nutrition. First one is there, that is autotrophic mode of nutrition. Now see this. This word only tells us about its meaning. Auto means what? Self. Okay. Auto means what? Self. And trops means what? Nourishment. Trops means what? Nourishment. So the living organisms can make their own food by using the different simple raw material. That living organisms or that mode of the nutrition are called as what? Autotrophic mode of nutrition. Or in simple word we can say that the organisms which makes their own food, okay, so all the organisms which makes their own food, that type of the nutrition are called as autotrophic nutrition. Okay, that types of the nutrition is called as autotrophic nutrition. And the organisms which follow this autotrophic mode of nutrition, that organisms are called as autotrophs. That organisms are called as what? Autotrophs. So what is the example of the autotrophs? Yes, you are correct. What is the example of the autotrophs? Yes, all green plants. Okay, all green plants is the example of autotrophic mode of nutrition, and that is the reason the green plants are called as what? Autotrophs. Why autotrophs? Because they can raise their own food. They can fulfill the nourishment by their own for their food. They are not depends on anyone. Next type of the mode of the nutrition, that is what? Heterotrophs. Now heteros means what? Other. So the organisms for their food, those what depends on other, that organisms are called as what? Heterotrophs. In that we can say all the animals including human vehicles under what? Heterotrophs. Okay, so these are the two types of the mode of nutrition in plants. So here we can say that the plants are autotrophic. Okay, the plants are autotrophic, or they are also called as what? Autotrophs. So if the plants are autotrophs, whether the whole parts of the plant is making the food or only the one portion or the only the some parts of the plants are making the food, that all the questions answer we are going to find out in our next video. Okay, so for today this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the nutrients, mode of the nutrition in plants, why the organisms are required the food. Also we have discussed the definition of nutrition, and also we have discussed about the autotrophic mode of nutrition. Organisms which follows the autotrophic mode of nutrition are called autotrophs, and organisms which are depends on other for their food. They are called as what? Heterotrophs. Okay. So my dear student, this is all about today. Today we will stop here. This is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.